So we are as mad as hell, and we are not going to take it anymore. So Triple H can stay home. We don't care if we never see him again. But it's nice to see you, Maria.
Very nice to meet you.
Thank you. Hey, over there. Come on. I just want to let you know there's no hard feelings about last week, even if you are one of the guys that jumped on Triple H. Come on, put it there. Well, let's let bygones be bygones, okay?
Oh my God, Batista! Bygones be bygones, my Oklahoma backside. Wow, look at man. Tajiri assaulted from behind by Batista after being set up by Ric Flair.
Well, that's that locker room revolution you talked about, and we're so happy about last week, JR.
Wait a minute. I think Flair and Batista are on their way out here.
Oh, I think they are too, Darren. If I were you, I'd make myself scarce because you were also happy about what happened to Triple H and Evolution last week. They may be coming right over here to...
Well, if you just joined us and you're missing Triple H, he told us in a, from some other location he was not going to be here live tonight on Raw.
At least they're going down to the ring. You're safe for now, JR.
Reap what you sow. I'm not the root of their problem.
No, you're right. It's all of those WWE super. Hey, get rid of that sign. Get that guy out of here.
The jury, one of the men out of the locker room last week that stood up to Evolution's pilot seat. And Tajiri has paid a price for that tonight.
Well, right. Tajiri was one of them. Do you remember how many people actually jumped Triple H last week? How many of those guys out of the locker room jumped on Triple H?
There was a whole bunch of them.
I can assure you that all of those guys are going to rue the day that they laid their hands on Triple H.
And I'll tell you what, all of them have issues with Triple H over the years as well. Every single one of them.
What happened to Tajiri is just the beginning. Last week, I repeat, last week was unacceptable. Whether you like him or don't like him, you all need to respect Triple H. He is your world champion. He is the leader of Evolution. And Eric Bischoff, either you restore order with Raw, or Dave Batista and I repeat, we will walk back there and destroy the entire locker room.
Uh-oh.
I'm better. I mean.
And I'm better well, than ever. When Evolution I'm speaks, better. People listen.
Well, there's our general manager, Eric Bischoff. Oh, look at the haircut.
Players, I am here for two reasons. Business and personal. On the business side of things, with Survivor Series being just 2 weeks away, I want to announce the Raw side of the card.
Oh no, haircut or not, here's a...
For the Intercontinental title, it'll be Christian versus Shelton Benjamin. For the women's title, it'll be Trish Stratus, finally, versus Lita. Yeah. Good. And in the main event, it is going to be a classic Survivor Series elimination match. On one team, you're going to have Chris Jericho. Uh-oh. Chris Benoit.
Oh, boy.
Maven. And Randy Orton.
Wow.
And that team will be facing Triple H, Batista, Edge, and Gene Snitsky.
Snitsky?
Did you leave my name out of there by mistake?
No, Rick. I simply didn't announce your name because you're not on that team. See, Rick, this brings me to the personal part. All right? You may not have liked the way things went down here last week, but I did. Which is why from now on, unless there's a specific match that I want to see, for example, like my nephew Eugene getting totally decimated by Gene Snitsky, well, then I'm going to continue to let the inmates run the asylum. You see, Rick, you come out here and you order me to do something about what happened last weekend, and normally I would. But a couple of weeks ago at Taboo Tuesday, as I was sitting in that chair, getting my head shaved, I kept asking myself, where's Evolution? Where is Evolution? The answer was nowhere. Let me take it a step further, Rick. Tell me exactly what kissing Evolution's ass for the last 2.5 years has gotten me. Absolutely nothing. Which is why from now on, I answer to no one but me. And it's also why, after Survivor Series, I decided to give myself a 1 month vacation. But there's a catch. See, the winning team of Survivor Series is going to win a lot more than a match. They're going to win absolute control. Because each week in my absence, control of Raw is going to go to the individuals on the winning team from Survivor Series, and they can make any match they want, no questions asked.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Bischoff. Now, if Maven, Jericho, and Benoit were in charge of Raw, all they would do is make championship matches for themselves against Triple H. Now, Randy Orton is unable to do that because of his loss to a very famous man. Woo! But he will stop at nothing to make sure that title is stolen from Triple H so he can get his little championship match. Now, I strongly, and I mean strongly, suggest that you reconsider that stipulation.
Is that a threat?
It's whatever you want it to be.
Well, I strongly suggest that you concentrate, if I were you, on making sure that your team is the winning team at Survivor Series. Because I've got news for you. Triple H may say that without him, Raw is nothing. Well, I say, without that world title, Triple H is nothing.
I'm better.
Wow. Boy. It seems to me that Eric may be changing his role as a general manager. And the inmates really are going to be running the asylum.
I'll tell you what, if it's anything like last week, what's the rest of this night going to be? But, man, what about that Survivor Series match? What's at stake there?
I don't know, but hooray for the inmates. I know one thing. I can't wait for Survivor Series. This is getting very interesting.